Here's example 3. It's a little different because at this point, if we try to add the x's and the y's together, we notice that a variable doesn't cancel out. And remember, what we're looking for is we want to have the same number in front but opposite signs for the variables. So in this case, our x's are different coefficients, so we don't want to use that, but the 4's are really close. What we need is we need one of them to be a negative. So we have 4y, and then we need one to be negative 4y. So in order to make that happen is that we multiply one of them by a negative or a negative 1. Then you have to make sure and distribute in order to change that a little bit. And so remember to distribute to all of the terms. So this bottom equation becomes negative 7x minus 4y equals negative times a negative is positive 14. Then we bring across the other one. 3x plus 4y equals negative 6. So now my y's cancel. So be careful. If I tried to add this, you would get 10x plus 8y, and that is not what we want. So make sure you don't do that. So here, our y's cancel. 3x minus 7x is negative 4x. And then negative 6 from 14, that is a positive 8. So we can divide by negative 4. So we see that x equals negative 2. Then we take this and plug it into one of the equations. So we can either plug it into here, this one, the original, this original, or we could even plug it into this negative that we made. It all works out. It's fine. So whichever one you choose. I'm going to go ahead and do the first equation at the top. So let's try it out. 3 times negative 2 plus 4y equals negative 6. So I want to solve for y. This is negative 6 plus 4y equals negative 6. Then we add 6 to both sides. And what we get is 4y equals 0. And then we divide by 4. So in this case, y equals 0. That is totally fine. So now that we have that, well, I can see at the bottom that I am correct, but we should go ahead and do a check. So let's check that out. Let's plug it into both. So we know that x is negative 2, y is 0. So 3 times negative 2 plus 4 times 0, does that equal negative 6? So negative 6 plus 0 equals negative 6, and yes, that is true. So that is correct. Let's try the bottom one. 7 times negative 2 plus 4 times 0 equals negative 14. So again, I'm just plugging in my x values into this second equation, the y value into this equation, and I want to see if I get a true statement. If I do, that means that this is correct, right? But it has to work in both. So this becomes negative 14 plus 0. Does that equal negative 14? So yes, negative 14 does equal negative 14. So if you want to try one more example, try this. This one you don't have to multiply because you can add it straight down. So go ahead and try this out. When you come back, I'll have the answer for you. So if you tried this out, you would have gotten y equals 4, and then you solve for x, you plug it back in, x equals negative 1. Then you do the check and you find that it works. And so negative 1, 4 is your solution. I hope this helps. Thanks for watching.